Hey everybody, welcome back to Fluency. We're on story number 19. I can't believe it. All these mysteries with Sam Sherlock and his dog Watson. Well, this is another one, the case of the bank robbery. We're going to start as we usually do with fluency practice. I want you to pay close attention though to phrasing of words, how I clump words together. To sound like we speak. Like, come on, Watson. That's the first. Come on, Watson. I'm clumping together because that's how we speak it. Here we go. Those are like phrases that go together. I don't just say it word by word. Okay, I'm trying to sound like I speak, like I talk. Okay, so I want you to pay close attention to those phrases today. And also the punctuation, as we always do. I'm going to pause at commas, pause a little longer at periods, make my voice sound excited at an exclamation point, and make it sound like a question when I see a question mark. Okay, look over at your partner, give them a little wink and a smile, and get ready to echo read. The case of the bank robbery. Come on, Watson. Here we go.
Oh, my gosh.
Why doesn't Sam play with Watson as often as he would like? Number 7. What was the bank manager's name? Eight. Do you think all banks have TV cameras? Nine. What did Mary say the robber was wearing? And 10. What did the videotape show? Awesome job thinking critically, guys. Now we're going to go back and finish the last part of our fluency practice. I would like you to turn away from your partner and whisper read the case of the bank robbery all the way through to yourself. And when you're finished, I would like you to turn back to your partner and read aloud the case of the bank robbery to them, and then listen to them read it aloud to you. All right, guys, pinky high five your partner, then turn your back and reread it to yourselves. See you next week.